maybe to answer your question again about daily mass, that's why I'm there. That's why we should all go to daily mass. You know, if Jesus is going to come down on that altar and sacrifice himself for me every day, you know, I'm going to show up for him because I want Jesus. Not just a symbol of him. I don't want a symbolic wafer. Like, I want the real thing, you know, and not just on Sunday. I want it every single day. You know, Jesus taught us to pray for that. God, you know, give us this day our daily bread. So that's what I'm doing. I'm showing up daily for that miraculous bread, for Jesus's real presence in the Eucharist. And I'm going to keep showing up until I get where I'm going, until the Exodus is over. And I would just encourage everyone to do that. I know it's not practical. Maybe not everyone can get to daily mass, but these things take sacrifice, you know, of our time and just kind of a shift of our priorities. And if you can't go to daily mass, come to Sunday mass a few minutes early. Just sit there and look at the sanctuary light and look at the tabernacle and know he's home and know that that's his real presence. Or, you know, go to confession or adoration or stations of the cross. We're just doing this to be with Jesus. And I really just think through the Eucharist, you know, there's no better way to receive him. He gives himself so selflessly that we can show up.
And Kirsten, you can hear in every gesture and every part of your voice the passion, the excitement.
Yeah.
And it's very, as I sit and listen to you, and I'm moved by the beauty of what's going on inside of you and how our Lord is speaking to your soul in these different ways with these new ideas of new discovery of new ideas and the connection of things which we've always had there sitting in our faith.
Mm-hmm.
So through all of that and this discovery of what can be considered new concepts,
mm-hmm.
to you, it's more than new concepts. To you, it's something that's touching your life.
Right.
It's making you change your mind about how you want to spend your time. It's making you change your approach to how you have a relationship with Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
The power of the Mass, we all know that that's one sacrifice and that we're able to participate in that and then almost like stepping into a time machine.
Yeah.
Or if you will, you know, I think the better way to say it is stepping outside of time, which, mm-hmm. you know, you mentioned. We step into Mass, we leave time and space, and we enter into a whole new mysterious realm. It's beautiful to see that that's moving you.
Thank you.
it's a wonderful, wonderful testimony, and I'm really happy that you're getting to share this with other people. And that you're not afraid to.
Oh, I'm afraid. It's the grace of God. I'm very nervous, but yeah. I mean, I'm humbled. I'm humbled. I'm you know, I hope I found the right words. And I like I said, I just want to encourage people to step out in their faith and go to daily mass or do something or read these books.